the coffee shop. Solemn Mass by the parish priest.
In the evening of that same day, the first day of the week, the doors were closed in the room where the disciples were for fear of the Jews. Jesus came and stood among them. He said to them, "Peace be with you," and showed them his hands and his side. The disciples were filled with joy when they saw the Lord, and he said to them again, "Peace be with you. The Father sent me, so I am sending you." After saying this, he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. For those whose sins you forgive, they are forgiven. For those whose sins you retain, they are retained." Thomas, called the twin, who was one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. When the disciples said, "We have seen the Lord," he answered, "Unless I see the holes that the nails made in his hands, can put my finger into the holes they made, and unless I can put my hand into his side, I refuse to believe." 8 days later, the disciples were in the house again, and Thomas was with them. The doors were closed, but Jesus came in and stood among them. "Peace be with you," he said. Then he spoke to Thomas. "Put your finger here, look, here are my hands. Give me your hand, put it into my side. Doubt no longer, but believe." Thomas replied, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "You believe because you can see me. Happy are those who have not seen and yet believe." There were many other signs that Jesus worked and the disciples saw, but they are not recorded in this book. These are recorded so that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that believing this, you may have life through his name. The Gospel of the Lord. Begin my few words with a little nostalgic journey, and I know this is only for the older people among you. Children will have no idea of what I'm talking about. Younger, middle-aged people maybe might have heard of it. Can you remember what it was like coming to Mass before the Second Vatican Council? If I say Latin, you might remember, because the whole ceremony was in Latin, a language most of us didn't know. Now, during that time, the name for this Sunday in English was the Sunday within the octave of Easter. That was the name, but it was printed in Latin, so we didn't know. Now, to the time of the Second Vatican Council, there was a great change in the liturgy. And you'll remember it was changed for us from Latin to English. So at last we knew what was being said, the prayers that were being said. But there are various other things, and the name for this Sunday was just.
"For having preached the gospel and witnessed for Jesus. It was the Lord's day, and the Spirit possessed me. And I heard a voice behind me, shouting like a trumpet, 'Write down all that you see, wooden girdle.' When I saw him, I fell into a dead faint at his feet. But he touched me with his right hand and said, 'Do not be afraid. It is I, the first and the last. I am the living one. I was dead, and now I am to live forever and ever. And I hold the keys of death.'
In the evening of that same day, the first day of the week, the doors were closed in the room where the disciples were for fear of the Jews. Jesus came and stood among them. He said to them, "Peace be with you," and showed them his hands and his side. The disciples were filled with joy when they saw the Lord. "Those whose sins you retain, they are retained." Thomas, called the twin, who was one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. When the disciples said, "We have seen the Lord," he answered, "Unless I see the holes that the nails made in his hands, and can put my finger into the holes they made, and unless I can put my hand into his side, I refuse to believe." 8 days later, the disciples were in the house again, and Thomas was with them.
Almighty Father, forever. Thank you. I'll give you one just in case. Yeah, just put it in the pocket if you don't mind that. I'm not giving you a cat, isn't it?
Okay.